Hi Scorpio, welcome back to Omkara Caro, and let's do another love check-in for you. So Scorpio, these are general collective readings, will not resonate with each and every one of you. So take what works for you, okay? Leave the rest. So let's begin. Dear God, Goddesses, Angels, Spirit Guides, this bestest reading for Scorpio and send them the messages they need to hear the most at this time. Thank you. So Scorpio, before we start your reading, let's start with a Ganesha Oracle card and an Angel Blessing card to top the reading and see how you're going to be blessed in your love life. So Lord Ganesha, can I have a card please for Scorpio, a blessing or an advice please? And one from my angels as well. One card of blessing or an advice from my angels, please. Okay, so this one and this one. Let's put the rest back, Scorpio. And let's see how my angels and Lord Ganesha are going to be blessing you. So the card I have for you from Lord Ganesha is Enlightenment. Beautiful card. And the angels give you wise decision. Says has there been something, Scorpio, that you are now becoming aware of? And if you now know the truth about something, it's time now to use that knowledge to your best and make wise decisions regarding the same. Let's see why these two cards are here for you today, Scorpio. Let's see how it's going to resonate with the rest of our reading. So welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for all your support to the channel. I'm very, very grateful. And if you're new here, we welcome you to our Omkara family. We meet here monthly, weekly, weekends, all the time. Yes, we welcome you. If you enjoy these readings, do subscribe and become part of us. We welcome you in. So newbies, let me explain this setup to you. I have one side for you, one side for your person, and in the center, I have your mutual energies. So for the duration of this reading, I will be referring them as person A and person B. And in this, you decide which side you resonate best with, okay? You know your story. I got a message from one of my subscribers saying, why can't you say, you know, Scorpio, you are here and you are here. But the point is, sometimes what happens is, I've seen some readers do that, and they go, Scorpio, you are this, you are that, you did this, you, and the person listening, it's very unfair to the person, because you know you're sitting behind the camera and you're listening to the tarot reading and you're saying, but this wasn't me, this is what was done to me, right? So it just makes you feel bad. So I didn't want to get into that. You know your story, you'll know whether you are here or you are here. So the other side obviously is your other person. Makes life so much simpler, doesn't it? So, okay, let's start with person A's energy. King of Cups in reverse. King of Wands in reverse. Seven of Pentacles. Temperance. Knight of Pentacles. And the Ten of Wands. Okay, this definitely seems like the masculine energy on the left side. Five of Wands in reverse, the Sun, Eight of Pentacles, Tower, the World, and the Wheel of Fortune. So, I also have the Six of Wands bottom of my deck, Scorpio. It seems somebody is really not feeling very victorious in this relationship, okay? There is somebody here who is trying to maybe manipulate or emotionally manipulate the other person because they're feeling a little unloved here. They're feeling things are not going their way. They feel, you know, things have almost come to an end here. They don't feel very passionate. They have no will. They feel if there was some possible way they could, you know, invest back into this relationship maybe and bring some kind of justice to it, and maybe have some return of their partner, that would be really nice, but I don't think it's happened yet because this person is feeling a little imbalanced and not very, they feel healing is not coming to this relationship as of now. So Spirit, who's this King of Cups? King of Cups? King of Cups? King of Cups. King of Cups is trying their best to bring justice to this relationship once again. They want a return. They want to have a fresh new start with person B, it seems. And they are trying every trick possible up their sleeve to kind of manifest this new beginning. Yeah, they keep looking back in the past as to how things didn't work out. I think this person is very regretful about the way things have panned out between them and this person, and now they are trying very hard. They're feeling very unloved, first of all. They're feeling they've lost out in the situation, and they want to do something which will initiate something new, maybe a return. But right now they know that things have really ended, I think, between the two of you. Person A is very, very restless, and they keep, I think, they're still dreaming and fantasizing about this love that they lost. Now they are now seeing person B, I think, with new eyes, and they know that maybe in the past they've been a bit selfish and they have not given to the connection, and they see the value of their partner now, to see what a kind, beautiful, loving person B is. And maybe person A is now realizing that all their selfish behavior, maybe they were very prideful, but now I think their pride and ego has taken a fall, and they feel things are really over. They would love to reinvest in this relationship, but they are not finding the words now. They have no clarity as to how to bring this healing back. So, Seven of Pentacles, spirit. Yeah, they know that they have been a little difficult in the past. Maybe they were in and out, maybe they didn't do right by person A, they were immature, maybe they were flirting around other places. So they know that because of all that, it's a little difficult to get a reconciliation maybe back with person B. And they are noticing that person B is not giving them any attention anymore, even though person A really wants to bring healing. And they know things have ended. They know things are really stagnant, but they would like it if somebody would make a decision and return back. So, Temperance spirit, yeah, person A is now looking for a fresh new beginning, a fresh new start. They are planning doing anything possible in their whatever they can to bring some kind of balance and a new beginning back. They are realizing that with the Knight of Pentacles energy in reverse, things have totally come to a total halt here. Yeah, again, I have the same card, Temperance. Okay, so this whatever was imbalanced in the past, they want to bring back harmony and balance back into this relationship, right? After this imbalance happened, things have halted, finished. They want to bring this back. So now, whatever burdens person A has been carrying in this relationship, or whatever has been burdening in this relationship in the past, person B is wishing to drop all this heavy load and begin anew, it seems. So, Ten of Wands spirit, Ten of Wands in reverse. Yeah, they don't want to go back and forth in their mind. They don't want to keep repeating the cycle of off and on. They want to drop the ball now and kind of just make one firm decision where all these burdens can be dropped and a fresh new beginning can be had. This is person A. This seems like the masculine energy to me. Let's see anyways what person B is going through. Person B has already dropped the fight. They are not in competition. They are not fighting. They are not competing. They are also making decisions, right? They are making decisions, but they are making a decision to not fight anymore. They haven't been happy, I think, in the past with the person A that much, but they are kind of keeping the peace. The Sun is in reverse. So Sun in reverse is a card of happy, but not that happy, right? So they're kind of tugging along, because in the past, I think they did love person A very much, but things really didn't pan out the way they did. And I think person B is now keeping themselves very guarded. They don't want to kind of fight with person A. They want to hold their ground. They want to keep peace, because there is a kind of friendship or a soulmate connection felt between the two of you. But I don't think actively this person wants to work on it either. They're not wanting to put in the work, because they have realized that their Ten of Cups with person A never really materialized. this led to a lot of heartbreak and a lot of competition, a lot of fighting. So I don't think person B wants to work on it, or feels that person A never really put in the work, right? But things are still kind of up in the air. The tower is in reverse. It's not that things have really crashed and burnt between the two of you. I think person B has just left person A to deal with their own karma now. They feel whatever you've done, I'm not going to interfere now, and I'm not fighting with you either. I'm just going to stand back and hold my own and let karma deal with the rest. I think person B has surrendered now to the universe. They know that the cycle is still kind of not ended, but slowed down to an extent where there's nothing really between the two of you. Maybe there's barely any conversation or communication either, right? But this chapter still remains open for some reason. Maybe there's something which ties you both together, which doesn't, it could be some kind of stability between the two of you. It could be some common ground of stability, which is could be children, could be a home, could be property, could be a business, could be something which offers both of you stability. And that's the reason I think both of you keep a level of decorum between the two of you. But the way person A is wanting a return, I don't think person B is fighting for that anymore. They are happy to leave it at status quo, just leave it, at maybe a very small friendly level here, where you guys can be friends and just keep things afloat, and not fighting for this connection. Because I think person B has tried it and it has failed miserably. Yeah, the person B feels that this relationship is very toxic, and it kept them chained maybe to person A for a very long time, and maybe there were addictions here. There was maybe person A was addicted to certain things, or person B was addicted to certain things. All that led to this tower moments, I think, which happened. So even though person B is trying to keep things afloat with, they are not really, I don't see them really returning. Yeah, I think person B is still kind of healing and going after their own wish fulfillment on their own dreams. They want their wheel of fortune to move ahead now. They don't want to move backwards, but they want to move forward in their own life. So let's see what this is. Wheel of Fortune, spirit. Wheel of Fortune. Yes, person B is no longer confused anymore. They are no longer in that confusion of should I go back, should I move forward. I think they've made up their mind, and they feel that whenever they've tried to work with person B, person, sorry, person A, person B feels it's always backfired on them. They've always been hurt maybe in the past. Now person B has become stronger. They are no longer confused. They are taking charge of their own life, and they are now the empress of their own life. Right? They are abundant, they are growing, they are in a good space, and they want to keep that level of decency, I think, between the two of you, and saying, hey, okay, let's be friends, and that's about it. And I'm moving ahead, I'm not confused about this connection anymore. One more card, spirit, for the Wheel of Fortune. Yeah, this person has made a firm decision. Right? They are not deciding, they have already made a decision. They are not confused anymore. They are the empress of their own life now, and they are working towards being their own star and moving towards a happier tomorrow for them. I don't see any return happening from person B's side. Person A, though, wants a start with them. So let's see what's happening in your mutual energies. The Lovers, the Devil, and the Eight of Swords. Yes, I think right now, if you guys have talked, there are decisions which are being made. A lot of enlightenment is coming about who wants what and who wants what. I think it's become clear to both of you that one person wants a re-beginning and the other person doesn't. So there are decisions and wise decisions, I think, being made here. About releasing, I think. Let's see. What is this lover spirit? What is this decision being made? One more. I think whatever decision is being made is making person A feel a bit sad. They don't feel as strong anymore because person B is now on to their own victory and their own success. Right? They are not looking back because this person looking away. So person B is now moving ahead to their own victory, their own happiness after having maybe felt like this in the past with person A. Whatever was done in the past has affected person B a big deal. And after feeling lost and feeling embarrassed and maybe publicly humiliated by person A, person B is now moving forward to their own victory. They're very, very clear as to the path that they want to go to. And that's making person A feel a bit rejected and weak here. So these are the decisions being made right now, Scorpio. And the devil is also in reverse. So any kind of toxic attachment is being released now. If there was a family structure in the past, if anything devilish, anything, you know, which was not making this relationship happy, this could have been a marriage, could have been a family situation, is in reverse. So somebody is releasing the toxicity of this partnership. And again, I have a feminine energy who's coming across as a Queen of Wands, somebody who is a go-getter and on to their own path for their own wish fulfillment. So yes, this person has put an end to the way things were in the past and is starting a brand new chapter and a brand new cycle for themselves. Eight of Swords in reverse, Spirit. Eight of Swords. Eight of Swords in reverse. Yes, after this day, wise decisions are made and the enlightenment comes that, you know, there is no way back to the way things were. And maybe, maybe you guys can still keep things open and be still friends or something. This is going to release a lot of self-imposed stress and tension. And once you guys can come to some wise decision here and end this conflict and pain and fighting and accept each other for the way you guys want to lead your lives, I think things can move forward in a very nice way, in a very amicable way, with enlightenment, to know maybe things have changed the way they were, but we can move ahead in a very healthy, happy and compatible way once again. Anything else, Spirit? Anything else for Scorpio? Yes, Scorpio, there may not be a passionate new beginning with them, but so sweet, how clear these cards are. There may not be a passionate new beginning the way person A wants with person B anymore, not the way you expected, but yes, there is a full possibility of you both kind of honoring the soulmate connection that you both have, or the past memories, the sweet memories, honoring those and still being good friends. Yeah, okay. So I think this is a very sweet reading. This tower doesn't really have to fall and end things, but yes, the way things were is no longer going to be, and the wheel of fortune is there once again. Scorpio, things will move forward, maybe now in a happier way, because you're not stressed and tense anymore about what to make of this relationship now, right? So maybe you guys will still be single, but abundant and happy, without any heartbreak between the two of you, right? And without any stress and tension between the two of you. I think that's a beautiful energy, Scorpio. Transform the way your relationship was. Don't have expectations. Make some wise decisions as to how you want to move forward. And this doesn't have to totally crash. Okay? That's all I have for you now, Scorpio. Love and light. Take care. And I will see you soon for your next reading.